nights I come in here and they crap on here to watch. And you're trying to listen to your iPod and it's the same stuff you listen to every day. So, at 11:30 midnight, you know, you want something different just to keep you awake. Some days better than others. Some days I just walk in silence. And I was fortunate tonight that there are a couple of people in here. Makes it a little bit easier for you. But when you're here by yourself, you're actually praying for somebody to walk in the door. Not so much as to talk to, but so that you feel human, you feel sane. You know, think about it, New Year's Eve, I was on here at midnight. Everybody else was out partying. I'm walking on the treadmill. You know, you pray for somebody to just walk in the door or even walk by the door outside. Signing with Weeder on Friday night, and I got a call, I got an email, you know, basically asking to call Tony about a shoot in New York for Muscle Fitness. It's a last minute thing where, you know, they're like, hey, you know, we want you to come up, we want to shoot you. So, you know, opportunity normally presents itself, you know, every now and then. When it does, you have to take advantage of it, especially for the sports that we do compete in. So, you know, at a drop of a dime, you know, to switch my entire schedule, knowing that pretty much a day and a half, I have to be in New York. You know, shooting with Mustang Fitness. So, you know, having to buy a train ticket at the last minute, preparing my food, all the food and a little bit extra to take with me, you know, still planning and making it back to the gym to actually do my workout for that day and my cardio, you know, because, you know, regardless of what's going on around me, you know, the show must go on. And my ultimate goal was to get ready for Flex Pro. So it doesn't matter what's being thrown at you, it's the opportunities that present itself, you have to take advantage of it, but you still need to stay focused, you know, stay true to yourself and know that, hey, at the end of the day, that's the bigger picture. You know, one of the reasons why we did this video is you have a lot of guys that's just coming into the sport that feel as if they start to get a headway and they have to be where everything is. They have to be in LA or they have to be, you know, in New York they have to be, you know, where everything is going on. You know, the simple fact is, you could live then up front, but when the opportunity does present itself, is you find a way to take advantage of it. As you look at it this way, there are guys in New York, but they didn't call someone in New York, they call on me in suburbia, you know, which is a 4-hour train ride. You know, so, you know, don't feel as if you have to pack up and leave in order to make it or to do good for sport. It's just a matter of taking advantage of the opportunity when they do present themselves and, you know, find a way. Where there's a will, there's a way. People fail to realize is that, you know, here we are, you know, went up to New York, you know, for the shoot. I had, you know, my team with me, Team Rhoden, and, you know, we get to the gym where they're doing the shoot. It's not a big gym, it's not a huge gym, it's just a small studio that they rented out. And I mean, they had 15-20 people in that room of their own from, you know, Muslim Fitness, you know, where there's makeup, the person that was oiling me down, they had, you know, the heads, couple of heads from, big wigs from Muslim Fitness, and it's like everyone is just jammed in this room. Interns, you know, those are the stuff that nobody really, you know, get to see. You know, the photographer, his assistant, the guy that does the lighting. I mean, there's so many people that, you know, people don't normally get to see what happened behind the scenes. They normally just see the finished product in a magazine and go, oh man, that's a great picture. You know, they don't see the work that's put into it. On the other hand, you know, from the Muslim Fitness staff to, you know, Team Rhoden that, you know, was with me in this journey. You know, so we want to be able to show everyone, you know, what it takes, you know, for the work that you guys see in the magazine and so forth, and the stuff that the athlete go through in preparation, as well as, you know, getting the perfect picture, the perfect shot.
I don't know how wide we're gonna get to go with this. Get the whole gym if I get the whole. So it's just something that makes it very really hot, and it's still like nothing, you know, crazy heavy, but still like heavy enough that it's.
You wanna do a plate?
Okay. One of these.
Do nail ones. Is that good?
That twisty side of Jimmy a little bit. Yeah, just bring your feet along, do a little bit of the gym.
Turn up a little bit. Too much, a little bit loud. Is that right there?
A lot of people don't realize that, you know, when you do actually do a photo shoot for, you know, a magazine or anyone in general, a professional, it's not just you walk in and it's snap a picture and it's over. It's repetition. It's like, we want to see that look in your face. We want to add more weight so we can see that look in your face. I mean, it's a 4 or 5 hour shoot, you know, of you walk out of there feeling drained, like, oh my God, I just had, you know, total body exercise, you know, and you're constantly being, you know, reminded, okay, do it again and hold it, do it again and hold it. That was perfect, but let's try it again. You know, so you don't get to just go up there and shoot a bicep workout. You know, it's a bicep, a back, a chest, an ab. You know, all different exercises where it's constantly one more time. You know, add more weight. We want to see this look. We want to see that look. But you take it and, you know, you smile and you just grind it out. And, you know, this is the sport that we choose. And, you know, either you enjoy it or you don't, and you quit. Me personally, I'm thankful and I'm blessed to be in the position that I'm in, to be able to be doing what I'm doing. And, you know, hopefully I get more opportunities like those to continue to do, you know, this wonderful sport.
Awesome day, man. A lot of fun. A little bit tired, lack of sleep, but it's a lot of fun, you know. This has always been a dream of mine to be doing what I'm doing. And I basically just be doing something that you enjoy doing. And I thank God for the opportunity to be able to be doing this every single day. Some days with a smile. That I really do enjoy what I'm doing. Man, who gets to eat 10 times a day?
You know, just for that one day with me going out the amount of adjustment that needed to be made as far as my meals, you know, the meals before, the day before and the day after. It was simple fact that when I had to call my nutritionist, Dave Kallick, up and let him know what was going on so we could make, you know, minor adjustments, you know. Then you have Team Rhoden that everybody's scrambling to make sure that I have the necessary stuff that I needed for that trip, you know, getting my meals ready and so forth. So it's a team effort, you know. And I'm very happy to have a great team, and, you know, everyone pulls in the same direction. But, you know, it affects as far as my meals for that day, you know, for the shoot, plus knowing that, you know, I still had to come back and train that night and shoot, you know, the flexing line, you know. Everything was just go, you know, making the adjustment in order to suit my workout, my energy, and so forth. Even on the ride back, you know, I'm not gonna lie, I was beat, I was tired, I was drained, you know, I was trying to take a nap in the train, it was loud, it was hot. I mean, in all honesty, the last thing in my mind was going to the gym to train. I just want to go home, crawl in my bed, go to sleep, and call it a day. And tired as shit, bro. But I'm trying to hit the gym, trying to get a quick workout in. The show must continue, no matter what's going on.
to the throne. Don't let me into my zone. Don't let me into my zone. I'm definitely in my zone.
Trying to get a quick shoulder workout in before the gym closes, so yeah, you guys bear with us. I'm a little bit tired tonight, so I'm gonna do my best. So hopefully I get a pump. I really truly need this shit right now. I'm tired as hell, so just a quick pick me up so we can blast some shoulders, and yeah, we're gonna try to have some fun tonight. It's been a long day. Did you guys see me crying? Someone please call my mom. Key pass to get in to do some cardio because they're kicking us out of here in a couple of minutes. Tonight I'm just gonna get 30 minutes in. Normally I'm here 45 minutes, but I'm just gonna get a quick 30 minutes in and call it a wrap.
What you say? That you only meant well, but of course you did. What you say? That it's
all. Pretty much after this, at home, eat. I'm gonna eat in the car. Hop in the shower and hopefully try to make it into bed by 12:15 to be back up to be in the gym 5:30 for my AM cardio. But I will be up for my 5:30 cardio. show must continue. Gotta stay in the grind and, you know, stay focused. It doesn't matter what obstacle we face. Yeah, my brother is a deacon. His name is Steve. And, you know, one thing that he always tell me is, like, nothing happened before its time. So, you know, I feel as if my time is coming and the opportunity is presenting itself for me to do well, or for me to do great. So just need to stay focused and, you know, do what needs to be done. You know, I really want to thank you guys for following me on this journey. It's been great. You know, we've been having a blast. I hope to do really well at both the Flex Pro as well as the Honor Classic. And whatever else that might be in front of me, whether it be the Olympia, you know, hopefully I get a chance to qualify to go back to the Olympia. You know, I want to thank my sponsors, Q&T, as well as Leader, AMI, for standing behind me and giving me the opportunity to do this wonderful sport of bodybuilding, to do something that I love. You guys stay tuned, and hopefully this journey will continue after the Honor Classic. We'll do the road to the Olympia. And a few workout videos. There's a few things that we have in the work as far as t-shirts, DVDs, autograph posters, and so forth that should be up on. It's not there right now, but coming soon on the website. So, you know, you guys just continue to follow us and shawnrhoden.com, and, you know, we'll keep you guys posted on Twitter as well as on Facebook. The journey has just begun.